Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Riesenbech. Just waiting for the game to load up. A little late getting started today. I had dropped in the latest beta build of Seasons earlier today, and, well, it didn't quite like the save game. So I had to kill Farm Sim twice, because I thought, what the hey, let's try it twice. Had to kill it twice, and now dropped in the released version of Seasons, and we are loading it back up. So, shouldn't have any issues loading it up this time around. Hey, David, DB, Anthony, what's up? So that is a great hint to always remember to back things up. Never know when you might run into problems. Checking on our animals. Look good. You know, Porky Pig. He looks good for the day. All right, let's hop over here and get to our project for the day, which is using our forage harvester and our truck to harvest this chaff. Already got the truck set up on Follow Me. Said I wanted to use this forage harvester when we started. Sometimes we have to coax Follow Me into working like we wanted to. Was going to use the secondary trailer also. I did my testing the other day, I had problems getting it to basically work properly. No, well, it's not new. It's been out in the mod hub for quite a while. First time we're using it here. But this came out in the mod contest. Hey Frank, what's up? So this particular harvester was part of the mod contest. And it goes along with their self-propelled mower. The same manufacturer. Follow Me seems to work best if we can keep our rows straight. Hey Alan, what's up? Also, it's best if we make very wide turns. We could also pull a trailer behind us if we wanted to. Then we'd have to do the old trailer jockey. Glad I can get your day started. We already went around the field a little bit. Open it up. Sometimes it can be a little particular. Hey, Bro F. I could also use course play, but I actually don't have that enabled on this particular save. Like I said, once we get done this little bit, most of the field will be a lot easier. It'll be more squared off. Hey, what's up, Big Tony? Hey, Native Texan, what's up? Helps. Hey, Sin Nuke, how you doing? So we didn't stream last night because I was not feeling so good. I was a bit under the weather. Feel like doing much of anything. I haven't seen, has it picked up speed at all? The last I looked at it was this morning. It was a cat too last I looked at it. Significantly down from what it was when it was hammering the Bahamas. Ah, so it's sped up a little bit. Whopping 8 miles an hour now. Said, now that we've done this part, most of the field should get a lot better. This prepped. Looks like, pretty much looks like the mower. It's a little different. Now, when I was looking at it, it didn't look like it was projected really to make landfall anymore. Of course, that doesn't mean much. The outer bands are going to be a lot of wind and rain. Still a lot of wind and rain. But if it's moving faster, that's a lot better than hitting Bermuda for, what, 2 days? Turned it off. This is what I was trying to do. Bring it over a little bit. Just leave it how it is. Say we leave how it is, and then I go bring him in. Yeah, folks, we're talking about the hurricane that hit the Carolinas last year. It was so slow, just basically stationary event, and that's pretty much how it was with the Bahamas too. Might as well have been stationary for as long as it took. Hey David, what's up? trying to encourage follow me to follow me. Alright, catch you later, Sinduke. Thanks for dropping by. I guess I could hire a worker on the forage harvester too. Do that next load. This field of corn to harvest. Got two more fields of corn to harvest. We're going to harvest that with grain. We've got to sell all of our harvest off. Sell our cows and our pigs off. And then we're going to move the live stream, at least, over to the map we started the other day. What was it? Name of it now. Starts with a K. We'll be doing the multiplayer next. Just need to finish this one out. Candlin, that's it. We'll be doing the multiplayer Candlin next. Once we close this one out. I was on there earlier today with some work. Control set. Better. It might be a little while. I think that was Darren that was going to do that anyway. He's working on a new secret project. It's an old running joke. Related to the folks that just take static objects out of the base game maps and make them placeables. Darren decided he was going to take a manhole cover out of Felsburn and make a placeable manhole cover. Full at some point. Maybe it's full now. Yeah, I had a hard time with Follow Me getting the truck to follow far enough ahead for its harvester to be able to empty into the trailer. This works better. Ideally, forage harvesting works best in multiplayer. I saw on the AccuWeather app, there looks like there's a couple tropical storms in the Pacific. Doesn't look like they're going to make landfall, but they weren't actually named. Kind of interesting. Do we only name Atlantic storms? If I turn traffic off, might have. I think, well, yeah. Waiting on it, right? I looked it up before I used Tropical Storm Marjorie. Apparently there's never been a Tropical Storm Marjorie. I used the good old Google. And it told me none of nothing. Hey Raz, what's up? I hear you had an eventful Labor Day. Our weekend we had two sick kids and then I came down with it yesterday morning. I'm all good now. My wife came home and told me she started having a fever around 3. See how she's feeling in the morning. Thing seems to have an incubation period of a few days. We kept our kid out of school on Friday with it. Had a low-grade fever. Thursday. Kept him out Friday. They may have like a 3-day incubation where it really shows any signs. Hey, what's up, Darren? We were just talking about your manhole cover. Blocked by an object. Saw that. Looked a little out of scale, too. Yeah, I wanted to use this at least once on the map. Put corn in here just for that purpose. might follow me a little bit, but it was a complete failure. Just go to the old tried and true. Hire a helper, drive along beside it. What else do we have? As far as contracts go, a lot of fertilizing, some balings. Not a lot of harvest contracts. I don't know if that is an issue or a trend with this map, or if that's just a trend in general with seasons. The numbers are going up. It's just fill animation, and the fill animation there doesn't always show. Numbers in the upper left are still going up. Yeah, it's either the harvester or the truck. The combination of the two. They don't overly like each other. Work, but there's kind of a fine window of opportunity. I want you to shoot the first trailer. We get that one filled, we'll shoot the back trailer. Shouldn't be your first time on this rodeo. Hey, Raz, was the guy that sold you the land down on Emerald Coast, is his name Chris? Went to the Century 21 office today, talked to a guy named Chris. Showed me a couple empty lots in town. empty all the way. Said one plot was due to an old fuel depot being abandoned after the storm. A little worried about maybe soil contamination. He assured me that all the respectable EPA tests were done and the land was cleared for industrial zoning. He was pretty clear. He wanted to make sure that I understood that that land was not intended for farm use. Not zoned for farm use. Especially wasn't zoned for live animals. Told him I had no intentions of putting any live animals on that. We at 112,000. We wonder how much this bunker would hold. Filled it full. Come on, let's go. Not too much left, just starting to get on the narrow side of the field. What? I know I hit it, you. Did I turn traffic off? Did. Patch, we missed. Seating, it was just too rough, I guess. We've seen lots of mods come out the first 2 days of this week. Let's hope they don't have problems. I think they were down to 158 mods pending testing. Must have cleared out a whole bunch. Feel a big old rejection stamp. I mean, things like the sheep pen. I don't know what the deal was with that big sheep pen. Anybody else try to use that big sheep pen? From last week? Apparently that cedar works in multi-cedar format with hired helper. but you can't get high multiples to start in manual mode. It was just acting weird when you put it down. It was like, it was taking a long time to actually register that it was placed. Like, you put it down, and the fence showed up, but the interior texturing didn't change. There weren't any collisions on the fence. If you went and looked at it in the shop, it wasn't there. And then a few minutes later, the rest might pop in. I tried it on a flat, on a prepared flat spot. When I first put it down, it showed up, but it didn't change the textures at all on the inside. Let's get up on this terrain. Some of this terrain. Wasn't throwing any errors or anything. There's a, you could go in as Seasons and specify this different distance textures for the Seasons. So like Midtown in 17, and then later Churn Farms was updated in 17, so that the distance textures are different for winter and summer. They may have also been different for spring and autumn. That's basically what it is. But you go in and you say that you're going to use this distance scenery for this season, that distance scenery for that season. With it. Hey, my account, what's up? Now you're gonna put it in gear. Okay. this load. Yeah, he's not really helpful, is he? That, these mirrors actually work. I saw a post on Facebook. It looked like they were updating Midwest Horizons for season support. Say this truck has a really nice dirt mask to it. Doesn't seem to have any wear. For example, we go there's full dirt. Just subtle enough to be noticeable. Not so bad that it's, you know, completely covered in brown. Nice if the wear mask was in properly, so that like the bin would inside of the bin would have show where the paint was worn off. Maybe the steps on the bumpers were worn down. Maybe a little paint around the handles is worn off. Definitely the paint around the hitch be all worn away. Oh, you're stuck. Oh, what a complete loser. Get things stuck and then you walk off the job. Better. Not. Plowing, huh? Happier with us. Go. Hey Chad, what's up? Just trying to do a little forage harvesting here. Times are having less than helpful luck. Pretty big setup. Care what trailer you shoot in, just shoot at one. Ready to go. Have better luck with this. There we go. We're just going to ignore the fact that we're going to be driving through corn. Come on. Well, genetic, this was part of the mod contest. It's not that new. Oh, they'll make it up in volume, Raz, right? Let's go. No, you don't want to pull forward because of your little collision box. Come on, we can do it. Yeah, you could. It does because it's a hired helper. Technically a hired helper, so hired helpers ignore crop destruction. Same way course play ignores crop destruction. It's just a hired helper. I don't think it's that they can't sell last year's crop, it's that they don't want to sell last year's crop, I bet. I've got to wonder if they're going to lose more crop as a result of it just being stored on the ground due to mice and rats and moisture than they would make waiting on a good price. What's that saying about a dollar in your pocket now versus versus later? Just gonna do this. Turn that off. There you go. That's it. Oh, I shouldn't be able to do that. I mean, you'd think the guys know what they're doing, right? So, I mean, they've got all this big equipment. They know how to earn a buck. So let's look at this harvester. So it's this harvester here. Of course, we can change its color, brown, green, blue. Change the rims. Of course, we have the chaff header. We have a mowing header for grass, cereals, so oats, barley, canola, wheat, and soybeans. We have a pickup header for snow, grass, and hay. Go compact this down, get it blanketed up. Oh, good luck, no such person. Hope you're well stocked. Ready to hunker down. Alright, catch you later. It's going to take a while, 5%. Was 200,000 liters. I think this gives us $800 a liter or 1,000 liters. So it's 800 times 184. That'll be a nice payday. Yeah, you should be protected from the storm surge and you just have the wind and the rain. So that could be its own problem. Hey Josh, what's up? Oh, we're just compacting the chaff we finally got harvested. Yeah, we can't bring in just a big chaff press. Let's see, what do we got? This. That might work. Head to the shop and find out. Take this guy back to the shop too. Won't need him anymore. See, our forage harvester only goes 16 miles an hour. Here we go. We're going the wrong darn way. Turn around, buddy. Long, slow ride to the shop. I saw this morning there was another Cat 3, might be bigger now, but it wasn't anywhere as close to any type of land. I don't think you're too far behind. This guy got in there. Must have planted wheat or something early. Oh, is that it? Yeah, I guess that was it. I was thinking about the name, that there were a whole bunch of letters between D and J. Oh no, it looks like... He did give up. Hey, if you're in such a hurry, you can pass. Oh, that's right, you can't. You're stuck. Well, you're just gonna have to wait then. You're gonna have to sit there and wait. I'm not gonna let you pass. Oh, a bunch of cars come up behind you. Where are you going? I wasn't going to let you pass. Finally made it, did you? Finally made it. All right. Thirty hours. Though in the latest build notes, they mentioned about something increasing the wear time frame. But with the current release version of Seasons, it's 30 hours of engine use. You'll see our tractor here, we've got 26.3 hours on it. We're at 88% wear. mean, what would be cool is if there was like a wear indicator, an hour timer from, you know, like a lifetime engine timer, and then a timer since last maintenance. You know, if I do maintenance on this tractor right now, is that hour timer at the bottom going to cycle to zero? It'd be cool if it just stayed at 26, but then the wear gauge, you know, went up. So let's look at that. So if we repair, okay, fully repaired, 9 does. The hours on the machine are still there. See, I cycled to the tractor and it's and has full wear, no wear on the gauge. Those 26 hours on it. That's nice for those role plays where you want to have a whole bunch of engine hours, but you don't want to suffer the consequence of a slow harvester. If I have any special action techniques. Hey, when I first started playing 17, the idea of compacting a bunker and using the leveler was a bit daunting. It's pretty intimidating. I think that's mostly because I've never seen that process done in real life. almost halfway there. I have to say, I think the roller helped out a lot. Even adds more weight. It's wider, so it distributes that weight out more. Unlike 17, I don't think in 19, I don't think you have the whole engine stuttering and not wanting to start if you don't repair it. Pretty flat. Now, this bunker is not wide enough, but I like to play the game of driving in circles. If the bunker is wide enough, then you can just kind of get in the bunker and just drive around in a circle. That compacts it pretty quick. Somebody that gets dizzy easy, then you might not want to do that. This covered now that it will be ready to sell last day of mid-autumn. It'll be fine. So hopefully the corn will be in by then. Stuck on the corner. -9% to go. Oh, Raz, you didn't miss much. You did repair the tractor and... You did repair the tractor and discovered that, that the engine hours stay, so that was pretty cool. 184. Almost 185. So if we get 185,000 liters and we get $800 a liter, it's $148,000. It's cooking away. Not anymore. Technically, we don't need this. I don't even know why it's down the shop. Never used it. Yep, scratches stay because we didn't repaint it. What's nice that I like is the engine hours, the hour timer stays too. Just like the animated shifter, the clutch, it's animated on this truck. Tractor, tractor. Oh, the tractor's cruise control is stuck at 17 from that other thing. That's why he's so far back. Yeah, you can do that. I did that when I moved the car from Churn Farms to Rathlin Island in 17. Kept the truck, gave it the same number of engine hours it had on it. Wait on our tractor. All we need to give these guys water, some food, give our pigs water, food, straw. Oh, here it comes. Hey, Tom, what's up? I tell you, having to feed these guys almost daily, every other day, sure does involve you more in animal care than having to feed them every 3 days, like we did in 17. or every 10 days like we had to do in base game. Put some serious time in. Oh, I've got to feed these guys almost every day on top of everything else I need to do. How's tomorrow afternoon? Oh, it's going good. Just finished forage harvesting a field. Finished compacting it, blanketed that up. We're coming over here to take care of our critters before day changes. Got just two more fields to harvest. They're not due yet. Weather shows pretty good weather next couple days. Hopefully we can get him in the next couple of days. We show rain the last 2 days of autumn. Did you see, Darren, I bought a green John Deere trailer for the water. Because I couldn't empty the water out of the other trailer for the slurry. I managed to actually get it out. I thought maybe we should just have a small tank for the sheep. It didn't look like they needed more than 3,000 liters a day, or every other day. Okay. Yeah, you got off right before I got on then. So I've got two tankers now. We got the black one for the slurry, the green one for water. Then we got a dump truck. Give these guys just this tank of water. We'll go and get the water for the pigs. Switch tractors. Ha ha. Did it actually let you dump it in the trough? That would have been a mess to clean up. I thought it was pretty cool that the trough dirt was manure. Yeah, we can see this tractor's got a decent amount of wear on it. Go in here. Now the tractor is fully maintained. It still has its dirt. It still has its wear. What we want to see. Yeah, apparently you can change all kinds of things with animals. I know somebody that's trying to do that at the geo level. Right now it's pretty easy to do, I guess, at the map level. Now, I was wondering if the manure was also piling up in the pit, as well as in the food trough. Kind of looked like it was piling up there by itself. This way, shorter. We'll be over on Candlin tomorrow night. Because I won't be streaming on Thursday. We'll stream tonight and tomorrow night. Thursday night, I've got to... got to be available to pick up our older kid who's going on a van trip. Won't be back until right about stream time. Well, the way I see it is that it's basically saying that the stuff that's dumped out on the floor is not edible anymore. It has no real use. It's just put it in the manure pile with everything else. It's non-edible scrap. Dump the water on the ground, why don't we? That's running. Truck. Hey, Ivan. What's up? Let's do a little corn. Let's see, how much do we need? Let's get 1,000 liters of corn and canola. Well, as far as size of the equipment, I would say kind of is governed by a few things. The number of folks that are going to be on the multiplayer server. You're going to play it kind of in a cooperative mode where everybody plays on the same farm and works toward a common goal or common goals. Or are you going to play it where people kind of run their own thing? There's multiple farms. It depends on the size of the fields, just like it would be with single player. And to some degree, the season duration. If you're going to play a really long season length, then you could play with smaller equipment because you've got the time to kill. If you're going to play where the server runs 24/7 versus pausing when empty, a server that pauses when empty, if you have a really long season duration, unless there's people on the server all the time, you may find that it takes a lot longer to get through the seasons than you thought it would because time only moves when you're on the server. Now, on the servers that we usually run that are seasons related, I usually set them so they don't pause, they just run 24/7. That way time passes even if no one's on. You have to think about how the clock speed that you want to run. A lot of it goes into that thought process. I wouldn't say that there's any right answer. Just really whatever feels comfortable, whatever folks enjoy playing with. Didn't quite fill up. Being close. Okay, so 4x map, 6 or 3-day seasons, cooperative. That would probably be, medium to big equipment. Depending on the clock speed of the server, we're running at 1x or 5x. And if the server ran when people were in it, or if it only was running when people were not in it, I mean, if you had pause when empty was enabled, then you wouldn't have to worry about time lapsing as you were, as no one was on the server. That would allow you to do a shorter season duration without running into a hassle. Problem talking about it. Hey, multiplayer is where the game really shines. Single player is okay, but it can get pretty monotonous. With multiplayer, there's a lot you can do to keep it fresh, and the just the interaction of other people really does keep it going. Alright, Darren, catch you later. Yeah, I mean, Candolin's got some big fields. Really big fields. Fix your cruise control. Oh no, you're a different tractor. Maybe that's why you're losing the trail. Well, yeah, look, you're set at 4 miles an hour. No wonder you were losing the trail. I mean, if you had like three people to... If three people were using a 6-meter cultivator, let's say. So that's just an 18-meter cultivator. Some of those fields you'd probably be cultivating for a good couple hours with three people before you'd even get the field done. But in the end, it really comes down to what you're comfortable with, and what you are, the amount of time that you all are able to put into it. I've seen some folks put in some serious hours on multiplayer servers, a lot more hours than I would imagine putting into it. Are you not giving me an unload trigger? Oh, I don't know. Okay, that there. Guys, we're going to stop it there because it is at the 2-hour mark. I'm going to go ahead and take these pigs some wheat. and call it there. Thank you guys for coming out and watching. Said we'll be on the Candlin multiplayer server tomorrow night. And what kind of trouble we can get into. Definitely have some fields to plant. We have some fields to fertilize. Got some sheep to take care of. And until next time, happy farming.